Hello students, today I am going to start the new chapter of M2, that is similarity of 10th standard. The first concept is, that is the ratio of area of two triangles. So see here, there are two triangles, that is ABC and XYZ. So you know the formula of area of triangle, that is half into base into height. So here is half into base, that is this B1 represents the base, that is BC, and the height is AM, which is denoted by H1. Similarly, in second triangle, that is in XYZ, YZ is the base denoted by B2, and the XN is the height, which is denoted by H2. So whenever we take the ratio of these two triangles, that is the ratio of area of two triangles, that is area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle XYZ, so what we get, that is half into BC into AM and half into YZ into XN. So half will get cancelled. So the remaining is the BC into AM, that is base into height, and here also YZ into XN. So they are denoted by, the BC is denoted by B1, that is base, and AM is the height. Similarly here B2 into H2. So what is the meaning of this statement? It is nothing but the ratio of area of two triangles is equal to the ratio of product of their bases and corresponding heights. So see here, bases and corresponding heights. So the ratio of area of two triangles is equals to the ratio of product of the bases and corresponding height. So you have to remember this one is the most important statement. Similarly, there are more three statements which you have to keep in mind to solve the examples. So the ratio of area of two triangles, the second statement, with equal heights. Now see, these two triangles having same height. So AD is H and PS is also H. So these two triangles are having same height. So what is the statement? The ratio of area of two triangles with equal heights are proportional to their corresponding bases. Now similarly, we have to take the ratio of areas of these two triangles. So first find out the area of this triangle ABC, which is half into BC into AD, that is BC into height, that is AD. Similarly, the area of this triangle PQR is QR into half into QR into PS. Now we have to put down the values. So first we take the ratio of these two triangles, that is area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle PQR is equals to half into BC into AD upon half into QR into H. So this half will get cancelled. So since AD and PS, these are the heights of these two triangles and both are same, here I write, that is AD is equals to PS is equals to H. So we put here the value, that is HH. This H will get cancelled, and so we get BC upon PR, which is nothing but the B1 upon B2, which is nothing but the bases. Means if the heights are same, then the ratio of area of two triangles is in proportion with their bases. Remember this one. The ratio of area of two triangles with equal heights are proportional to their corresponding bases. Now the third statement. So in this example, heights are same. Now we are going to take the bases are equal. Now see, the ratio of area of two triangles with equal bases are proportional to their corresponding heights. The statement is just like the converse of this statement. Means if the bases are equal, the ratio of area of two triangle is proportional to their corresponding heights. And in this example, if the heights are same, then the ratio of area of two triangles is proportional to their corresponding bases. Now see the figure. So first see this figure, that is triangle ABC, and in triangle PQR the bases are same. We have taken the bases are same, and so the height of the first triangle we denoted it as H1, and the height of the second one is H2. First we take the largest triangle first. So here we find out the area of triangle, that is half into base into height, that is half into QR into PS. Similarly, the area of the triangle ABC is half into BC into AD. So for taking the ratio, write down the first largest triangle. So area of triangle ABC, we're taking this triangle first. triangle ABC. Upon triangle PQR, this triangle is equals to, just write down, that is half into base into height. Since the base, that is QR and BC, are nothing but the B. So instead of writing BC, we write B into AD as it is. Similarly, half into, instead of writing QR, we write B into PS. So this will get cancelled and we get AD upon PS, which is nothing but the height. Means if the bases are same, the ratio of area of two triangles are in proportion with their heights. Now the next important statement, that is the ratio of area of two triangles with equal base and equal height is 1:1. Means if the bases are same, heights are same, then both the area of both the triangles are also same. Means the both the triangles having equal area. Means if the height and base are equal, then the area is also equal of the triangles. Now we are going to start the practice set 1.1. So first one, that is the base of the triangle is 9 and height is 5. So base of another triangle is 10 and height is 6. So find the ratio of area of these triangles. So two triangles are given. So we consider that the base, height and area of first triangle is B1, H1 and A1. So B1 is the base, height and area. Similarly for the second triangle, the base, height and area of the second triangle, we consider it as a B2, H2 and A2. Now we know that the ratio of area of two triangles is equals to the ratio of product of the bases and its corresponding height. So we taking A1 upon A2 is equals to B1 into H1 upon B2 into H2. The reason we are already given here. Now we have to just put down these values which are given in your example. A1 upon A2 is equals to B1 is 9 into H1 is 5, B2 10 and H2 is 6. By solving this, we get the answer is 3/4. Now see the next example. So in the figure, BC is perpendicular to AB. Now see, BC is perpendicular to AB and AD, see here, AD is perpendicular to AB. Now see, in this figure, both the triangles having same base, means these are the triangles with equal base. So ultimately you know that is the, if the triangles having equal base, then the area of these triangles is in proportional to with their heights. So the example is BC is equals to 4, that is height of this triangle, and AD, that is 8. So we have to find out the area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle ADB. So the first statement is area of triangle ABC upon area of triangle ADB is equals to BC upon AD, which is equals to 4 upon 8, which is equals to half. Why? Because these are the, because the area of the triangles with equal bases, means they having equal base, then their area is in proportional with their heights. Now the third example. In the following figure, PS is perpendicular to QR. See here, PS is perpendicular to QR. And QT is perpendicular to PR. If RQ is equals to 6, PS is equals to 6, PR is equals to 12, then find the QT. Now see, we are going to solve the examples like this way. That is, we have to write down the number, statements and reasons. If possible, draw this line here. Two lines in between statement and reasons. So see here the first statement which I have given, that is QR is equals to 6. See here, QR is equals to 6, PS is equals to 6 and PR is equals to 12. Just the things which I have given in your example, just we have tried down its your first statement and the reason is given. Now see the triangle PQR. See here the triangle PQR. So we can find out the area of this triangle by two way. That is, if this one is the triangle PQR, so this one is the base, QR is the base and this PS is the height. So half into QR into PS. So it is by the formula of area of triangle. So this one is the reason for this one. So half, so we are given the value of QR, that is 6, and the PS is also 6. So 2 3s are 6, so 6 3s are 18 unit square. This is nothing but the area of triangle PQR. To find out the QT, we have to find out this one. Now see, where is QT? So this one is the QT. Again, we are taking the triangle PQR. Now in this figure, or in this case, we are taking the PR as a base and QT is a height. So see, area of triangle PQR is equals to half into PR into QT. See here, PR, that is base, and QT, that is height. Now here we already find out the area of triangle PQR, that is 18. Half into PR is 12 and QT. The reason for this one is also the same, that is by the formula of area of triangle. Next one. So 18 is equals to 6 QT. So QT is equals to 3 cm. Now see the fourth example. So in the following figure, AP is perpendicular to BC. Now see, AP is perpendicular to BC. And AD is parallel to BC. See here, AD and BC, these are the two parallel lines. And everyone knows that the distance between the two parallel lines is the same. So the height of this both the triangles, that is ABC, find out ABC, ABC, this triangle. And second one, that is BDC or BCD, BCD. The height of both these triangles must be same. Why? Because they are in the, both the triangles are located in the parallel lines. So we have to find out the ratio of area of two triangles, that is ABC and BCD. So since both the triangles are in the parallel lines, see here, I am going to show the figure again. Since both the triangles are located in the parallel lines, means the height of both the triangles are same. And one more thing, that is both the triangles having same base. See, ABC is also on the base BC, and BCD is having also the same base, that is BC. Means in this figure, both the triangles having equal base as well as equal height, and so they are equal in their area. So see, triangle ABC is equals to triangle BCD, directly right here. And the reason, that is the area of two triangles of equal heights and equal base. And so the area is, the ratio of area is 1:1. Now see the question number 5. So in the adjoining figure, PQ is perpendicular to BC. See here, PQ is perpendicular to BC, as well as AD is also perpendicular to BC. Then we have to find out the following ratios. So first, the ratio is number 1, that is area of triangle PQB. So see here, P, Q and B. And next one is PBC. Now see, P, B and C. See, both the triangles, that is PQB and PBC, both the triangles having same height, that is PQ. Means if that both the triangles having equal height, then their ratio of area is corresponding, or it is proportional to their bases, corresponding bases. So what is the base of triangle PQB? PQB, the base is QB. And for PBC, the base is BC. And so the answer is QB upon BC. So the reason is the area of triangles with equal height are proportional to their corresponding base. Now the next one. That is triangle PBC and triangle ABC. First find out PBC. So see, P, B and C. And the second triangle is ABC, A, B and C. So just see carefully, that is the first triangle is PBC. So in both the triangles, the base are same. See here, for PBC, the base is BC, and for ABC, again the base is BC. Means these are the triangles having same base or equal base. So the ratio of area is proportional to their corresponding height. So what is the height of BBC? It is PQ, and the height of ABC is AD. So your answer is PQ upon AD. So these are the triangles having equal bases. So they are proportional to their corresponding heights. Similarly, so the triangle ABC. Now see the triangle ABC and ADC. A, B, and C, and A, D, and C. Again, here the height is same for both the triangles. See, the first triangle is ABC and second one is the ADC. So these are the triangles having equal heights. So their area is, or the ratio of area is proportional to their corresponding bases. So what is the base of the first triangle? That is ABC. The base is BC. And the ADC, the base is DC. So the answer is BC upon DC. So area of triangles with equal heights are proportional to their corresponding bases. And the last one, that is ADC and PQC. See, ADC and PQC. So both are the different triangles. No anything is common. That is, not their bases are common, and also heights are also not common. And so these are the two different triangles. So if the two triangles are different, then the ratio of area of these two triangles is proportional to the ratio of product of their corresponding base and height. So what is the name of the first triangle? That is ADC. ADC. So the base, that is DC into AD. So DC into AD. And PQC. See a PQC. What is the base? That is QC into PQ. So the reason is the ratio of area of the two triangles is equal to the ratio of product of their bases and their corresponding heights. So this is all about the practice set 1.1 of the chapter Similarity of 10th Standard. The remaining concept we will see in the next lecture. Thank you.